Great Baltimore Fire. Despite fire engines from nearby cities responding with horse-drawn pumpers, wagons and other related equipment carried by the railroads on flat cars and in box cars, many were unable to help since their hose couplings could not fit Baltimore's fire hydrants. Progression of the fire. Fire was reported first at the John Hurst & Company building on West German Street at Hopkins Place in the western part of downtown Baltimore at 10:48 a.m. on Sunday, February 7, and quickly spread. Soon, it became apparent that the fire was outstripping the ability of the city's firefighting resources to fight it, and calls for help were telegraphed to other cities. To halt the fire, officials decided to use a firebreak and dynamited buildings around the existing fire. Fireman Mark Kelly and Fire Lieutenant John McNew also died of pneumonia and tuberculosis due to exposure during the Great Fire. The National Fire Protection Association adopted a national standard for fire hydrant and hose connections. 100 years after the Baltimore Fire, only 18 of the 48 most populous American cities were reported to have national standard fire hydrants. The Herald printed an edition the first night of the fire on the press of the Washington Post, in exchange for providing photographs to the Post, but could not continue this arrangement because of a long-standing arrangement between the Washington Post and the Baltimore Evening News. For the next 5 weeks, the Herald was printed nightly on the press of the Philadelphia Evening Telegraph and transported 100 miles to Baltimore on a special train, provided free of charge by the B&O Railroad. The fire also devastated the city's other major newspapers, including The Sun with its famous iron building, considered the forerunner of modern steel skyscrapers, built 1851 at East Baltimore Street. The Box 414 Association, which has assisted the Baltimore City Fire Department for many years, acts like a local American Red Cross, or military United Service organization, sending refreshments and break time trucks to the sites of major alarms and fires to provide exhausted firefighters some comfort and snacks. The Maryland Historical Society commemorated the fire's centennial in 2004 with a website, two books and various events, lectures, and tours through the auspices of the Fire Museum of Maryland on York Road in Lutherville, Timonium, Cockeysville in Baltimore County,